for children 5 to 11 years of age. So there's been 1.8 million COVID infections in this age group in the U.S., resulting in more than 8,000 hospitalizations and 94 deaths. And so this means that COVID for 5 to 11-year-olds, COVID is tied for the 8th leading cause of death over the last year. So it can be quite serious, and that's why parents need to seriously consider getting their kids immunized. What Pfizer did was they did some dose ranging studies. They wanted to use the dose that was large enough that it would induce a good immune response, but not too large, which would be more reactogenic and resulted in more side effects. And what they found was using 1/3 the adult dose, given on the same interval, two doses, 21 days apart, resulted in excellent antibody responses with acceptable side effects. And so when they did the pivotal study that led to the emergency use authorization in the 5 to 11-year-olds, what they found was that the immune response was the same or better compared to the older children, 12 to 15-year-olds, and the young adults, the 16 to 25-year-olds. And they found that the adverse effects following immunization were very similar or in some cases less compared to those older age groups. You know, the common side effects are very similar to what occur in older children and adults. So a sore arm, which usually lasts a day or two, you can get swelling at the injection site, fever, headache, fatigue. This generally lasts a day or two and go away. If your child does have significant side effects, most of these will respond to anti-inflammatories, acetaminophen, ibuprofen, or others. It's not recommended to give those ahead of time because they theoretically may blunt the immune response to the vaccine. But giving it after immunization, if those side effects do develop, can make your child more comfortable. I think what many parents have heard of was myocarditis, which does occur post-vaccination with increased frequency in children, in younger adults and children, and especially has a predilection for that occurring in boys. This is incredibly rare, but of course it's scary because it does involve inflammation of the heart or the lining of the heart. Almost all these cases are mild and the children recover uneventfully. What most parents don't realize is you can also get myocarditis from having COVID. And what the FDA did when evaluating the vaccine for 5 to 11-year-olds is they took very conservative estimates of myocarditis, relatively high estimates of myocarditis that may occur after vaccination. And then they ran them through several different scenarios of COVID risk and post-COVID myocarditis. And in 5 out of the 6 scenarios that they ran, there was no question that getting vaccinated was far beneficial than any risk from vaccine and was better for the children. It's interesting, if you get COVID, you do get a good immune response to COVID itself. It turns out that that's equivalent to somewhere around maybe one dose of the vaccine, not two doses. So the immunity that you get is not as good as you get from vaccination, and it's not as reliable and consistent as that's obtained from vaccination. And in fact, the CDC had a recent study that compared immunity among those people who got COVID and among those people who were not infected but got two doses of the vaccine. And if you relied on immunity from COVID rather than vaccination, your chances of getting COVID were 5 times higher. So that just shows you how much better it is to be vaccinated to get protected against COVID. You know, we've been using vaccines in the U.S. for over 200 years, and the longest term side effect that's ever been found from vaccination has occurred 5 weeks following vaccination. And that was with smallpox vaccine, which we know had a lot of reactions and which we don't use anymore. The current vaccine that we're using for COVID, the mRNA vaccine for children, acts basically like an inactivated vaccine. So almost all the side effects that you would expect would be within the first few days after immunization, not even 5 weeks later. So there's no theoretical or biological reason to think that we would get any long-term side effects that would occur months or years later. There's no biologic reason to think that the vaccine would result in any changes to fertility. The vaccine does not affect hormone levels. There are no signals from the adult studies where people did get pregnant during the studies. And really, there's no theoretical or biological reason to think that the vaccines would affect fertility in any way. The thing that we worried about in children that's somewhat unique compared to adults is that children may get MIS-C, the multi-system inflammatory syndrome in children, which occurs 2 to 4 weeks following infection. And those children tend to be very sick with a lot of inflammation, often requiring intensive care unit care. So they can be very sick with that. One thing that parents should also think about is the risk of long COVID. Long COVID may occur after being infected with getting a severe infection, mild infection, or even asymptomatic infection in children. So that's one more reason to vaccinate your child, decrease the risk of infection, and decrease the risk of long COVID, which can result in symptoms for weeks and really interfere with children's experiences, including school.